Hey guys, what is going on? It is me, BakuriBox12 here, and welcome back to another Steambirds Alliance video, or as I like to call it, as of today, the game has officially been released out of beta onto Steam and is ready to be consumed by the masses. That's you, by the way, so you better play the freaking game. Alright, so since I've already done a couple videos covering the basics, I figured now would be a good time to get a bit more specific. So today we'll be taking a look at the high-tier dungeon from the raw generator, The Dig. It takes place inside a long series of tunnels with a giant drill at the start. Your task is to guide this drill all the way to the end, burrowing through the various stone walls that you would not be able to pass otherwise. Okay, technically you can slowly break the walls by hand over time, but no. Along the way, you'll need to protect the drill from waves of mines, turrets, and large groups of enemies. So you could definitely classify this dungeon as an escort mission of sorts, only, you know, it doesn't suck. The drill has its own health bar, there are these medic ships off to the side you can use to repair some of its health should it suffer massive damage, and before some of the rock walls, there will be a box of abandoned supplies that can yield some higher tier loot, in addition to the legendary abandoned supplies found only at the very end. So if you want to get the really good stuff, then you have to keep that drill safe the whole time. And it's not easy. I watched a guy solo it on YouTube before doing it, so I thought, ah man, if he can do it, then surely a group of us can. And I died. Yeah, you might be able to get through the first couple of waves on intuition alone, but after that, it's on. Even when I went with a pretty large group, I still managed to get myself killed. That's mainly because I dropped my IQ for a moment and stood next to enemies who clearly only wanted my lunch money, but nevertheless, The Dig is a hectic dungeon all about testing your group micromanagement skills. You want to do this with as many players as you can and with as much class variety as you can, especially if you don't have high tier equipment. You're gonna need healing, shielding, damaging, and plenty of those three. Ideally, in the words of a reputable duck, you want to clear the mines before anything else. They're often placed right in front of the drill and they do huge chunks of damage. Afterwards, the towers and turrets take priority, as they too have substantial firepower, but at a longer range. As for the enemies, while they can multiply quite briskly, you only really need to clear them out for your sake. If you let too many crowd the screen at one time, then it's going to impair your ability to clear out the mines and turrets, and will obviously increase your risk of death. It's like the side effects they read out on every medication commercial ever. I'm not saying you're gonna die, but you might. In layman's terms, take out the enemies that you can, but only after the mines and turrets have been taken care of. And don't sweat it if you let a few slip through the cracks. The most efficient way to complete The Dig, aside from being a literal god, is to fulfill your group role. I recently started playing the quad again, and since I died so many times trying to get footage for this dang video, I was able to upgrade some of its skills in the pilot school. Since I'm playing the role of a damage dealer and supplying a group damaging buff, I wanted to look into some of the stats that would improve that role. For example, there's a perk that increases my ship's attack range at the cost of a higher ammo cooldown, but next to that is a second perk that decreases my cooldown each time I upgrade it, effectively nullifying any downsides to the other ability. And after doing that, I could see how much fun the skill system could be, especially when you unlock all the classes and expand your tree of abilities. It's a really smart way of accommodating veteran players while also incentivizing newer players to keep moving forward. Because every time you die, instead of going back to the same drawing board like in Realm, you can make your starting character a little bit better each time, so that the leveling up process doesn't feel exactly the same. And even when you're all decked out in high tier gear, those perks will still be in effect. I'll be honest, I didn't pay much attention to this feature in the beginning, but now that I'm starting to understand it more, I realize how important it is to the Steambirds' identity, which reminds me of another neat feature this game has. Dungeon modifiers. I hadn't noticed it before, but when I entered The Dig for the first time, I saw this prompt that read, Dungeon modifiers, detailing both a positive and negative alteration of our attributes. For example, it could tell you that the steam cost of your abilities or maneuver has been decreased by a certain percentage, but the amount of damage that you intake has also been increased. A little bit of good, a little bit of bad. You're not sure what you're gonna get each time, and depending on what you get, your experience will be slightly different. It's a fun little way of helping repeat playthroughs of the same dungeon not feel identical. And in a game genre that is already pretty heavily influenced by intentional RNG, this sort of thing feels right at home to me. Another thing to note is that The Dig is basically an auto-scroller. You're constantly guiding this drill that never changes its speed, and you can't progress further until it reaches the next wall. In other words, because you're not in control of the pace, The Dig will almost always take you about the same amount of time to complete on each run, approximately 10 to 12 minutes. It's no marathon, that's for sure, but it's certainly no quick jaunt. And for something that I assume is meant to be one of the more difficult areas, I think that's a perfect time. Not to mention, it shakes up the standard dungeon tropes of running through rooms, clearing minions, and teleporting to the boss, loss, and replaces it all with the escorting of this drill under increasingly more demanding circumstances. The best advice I can give from what little I've done is to not let yourself fall behind. I got separated from the group at one point and was left with a bunch of heavy hitters that I couldn't clear out by myself. I also wasn't able to help out the group clear any mines because I was so far behind. Just be as attentive as you can be, sticking nearby the drill and a little bit in front, if anything. When all else fails, just stick with the group. They'll show you what to do, and I'm sure they'll tell you in chat as well. Generally speaking, you'll be pretty tightly huddled up anyway, so that shouldn't be a problem. There are two mini-bosses that you'll encounter. I didn't see them. They must have died when I was lagging behind, so I unfortunately can't show it off. They're there, trust me. But I did get to fight the buried guardian at the end, who looks like this giant beetle with a tail. It was pretty cool, seems like a nice guy, but I won't be getting any closer than I have to, because I like my skin on my body. Then once you beat him, he explodes, he screams, and you finally get your shot at legendary loot. I forgot to hit the box though, so I didn't get anything. Overall, the dig is a super unique area of the game that definitely lives up to its own reputation. As I said in the beginning, Steambirds Alliance has officially been released on Steam. The devs are super excited to have it out. It's free to play, has a lot of passion behind it, a dedicated player base. What I'm trying to say is, if you don't play this game, I will burn your house down. Well, actually, that's a bit extreme, but you should play it. It's good. Well, anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Before I go, I do want to mention that if you already own Steambirds Alliance on beta, you will have to go and install the new official version because the one that you have will not work. So go have some fun. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, don't forget to check out the next episode whenever I post it, which will probably be soon. All right. See ya.